Today we're adding water to a radiant system. I have two manifolds on the job site today. I have a 1-inch stainless steel manifold that has 4 ports. I also have an Uponor EP manifold that also has 4 ports. I like using both of these manifolds, although I prefer to use the stainless steel in most applications. This one comes with a 2-port through 12-port configuration. My favorite feature about this manifold is that it comes with isolation valves on the supply and on the return lines. The EP manifold is nice as well. The one thing I don't like about this one is that the isolation valves are missing. By the time I end up adding those in, they end up costing me more than the stainless steel manifold. I do still like using the EP manifold because if I know that I'm going to be adding onto the system later on, I can always remove these and add additional loops onto the system as needed. Adding water to either one of these manifolds works the same way. This manifold isn't connected to a water supply, but that's not a problem. This manifold has threaded connections on both the supply and return lines where I can hook up a garden hose and run water from a hose bib into this manifold to fill it up and fill all the other loops up. Also on each one of these is a valve that I can control the flow of water through the manifold as well. I have a 5-gallon pail that I can dump the water into, and even if I don't have a hose bib, I can use stored water and a pump to fill these as well. First, hook up the supply hose to one of the manifolds. You should also attach the drain hose to the other manifold. These knobs on the top of the manifold control the flow of water to the individual loops. Start with each of these in the closed position. Next, turn on the water to the hose and open a single loop. This will fill both the manifold chamber with water and start filling the loop. Water will eventually begin to flow through the drain hose. Allow the water to flow until all the air is purged from the loop. Once the air has been eliminated, close that loop and open the next loop on the manifold. Continue the process until all the loops have been filled. If you don't have a water supply connected to your manifold yet, that's fine. You can always do that later on. Just remember, before you fill those supply and return lines, that you purge all of the air from them before you open up your individual loops. Failing to do so is going to introduce air into those loops and cause problems in your heating system that you'll need to fix later on.